गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू पूर्णचंद्र हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल बारीगोदा। सो इन दिस सेशन वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द थर्ड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ गॉस लॉ। द थर्ड एप्लीकेशन इज दैट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड ड्यू टू यूनिफॉर्मली चार्ज्ड स्फेरिकल सेल, व्हिच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। सॉरी, सो इन द प्रीवियस टू सेशंस और इन द प्रीवियस टू वीडियोस वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द टू application of the Gauss law for a line charge and for a surface charge. In this session we are discussing about the electric field due to uniformly charged spherical cell. Okay, so let us look at the figure number 1. Okay, let us look at the figure number 1. This is your figure number 2. Laterally we are moving into the figure number 2. So first of all, look at the figure number 1. Okay, so this is not the dotted one. Again, I will repeat, do not look at the dotted spherical cell. Look at this solid spherical cell. This is your spherical cell. Okay? So let us take a spherical cell having a radius r, capital R. So I will take a spherical cell, okay, which is having a radius r. And these spherical cells, remember, these spherical cell, the charge is reside on the surface, and as it is a your surface, so that's why what type of line charge density will take? Surface charge density. So that is written here, this is sigma. Look at here, this is the sigma. Sigma is nothing but your surface charge density. I've written here, this sigma is surface charge density, which is nothing but the total charge divided by the area of this spherical cell. Okay, so that means the total number of charge reside or present on this surface of this spherical cell. Remember one thing. Okay, so now our aim to find out what? Now that to find out the electric field intensity, okay, due to this spherical cell at some point. Where the point present, I will discuss later one. I have to find out the electric field intensity at some point due to this spherical cell. Okay, so there may be three cases, because there may be in your mind there may be a question arises. Sir, this point may be present outside the cell. This point P may be present on this spherical cell, and this point P may present inside the spherical cell. Okay, so there are three cases can arise. Okay. In the first case, look at the first figure number 1. In the first case, the point P, I'll mark here, this is the point P, where I have to find out the electric field intensity. This point P is present outside the spherical cell. This is not inside. This is in the first case. In the case number 1, okay, the point P is outside the spherical cell. Okay, so for these three cases, we have now derived the value of electric field intensity for the first case, present outside the cell. For the second case, present on the cell. Okay, and for the third case, that is inside the spherical cell. Okay, so first, look at the first one. That is, the point is outside the spherical cell. So this point P is at a distance r. This is the radius of this spherical cell. But small r is not the radius of the spherical cell. Small r is the radius of this Gaussian surface. Remember, where it will come? Now, due to this charged spherical cell, and which type of charge? Remember, positively charged. That's where the electric field lines becomes outward. That's why it is clear that this charged spherical cell is white. What type of charge? Positively charged. Okay. And due to this positively charged spherical cell, what type of Gaussian surface I will take? A spherical type of Gaussian surface, or you can take a circular type of Gaussian surface. Okay. So this is a Gaussian surface which is having a radius r. And the point P is present on this edge of Gaussian surface. So for this point P, we are going to find out what is the value of electric field intensity due to this spherical cell. So again I'll repeat, for this I have to first find out what is the flux, the same process, what is the flux due to this spherical cell. So let us find out. So phi is equal to close integration over E dot ds, the same thing. Okay, so that at this flux is for the point outside this one, the case one. So close integration E dot ds, look at here, look at here, the direction is electric field is this and ds is also this, so that's why the angle between them is 0 degree. Okay, so that is integration E dot ds. E ds cos theta, theta is 0 degree, so that is simply ds. Okay, so this is E ds, there is something. So that is equal to E integration over ds over this surface, and which is nothing but I will get E into s. S means the surface area of this spherical cell. What is the surface area of the spherical cell? 4 pi r square. What is the surface area of this spherical cell, of this Gaussian surface? Because look at here, I have to find out at point P, not this, due to this, but I have to find out this. So that's why I have to take this surface area. Remember, not this, this surface area. The, for this surface area, what is my radius? R. So that's why ES is equal to, what is the S value? Now E 4 pi R. R, what is just capital R, because capital R is the radius of this spherical cell. But we are going to find out for this point. So that's why the radius is, or the distance is R. So that is E 4 pi R square, small R square. Okay. So that implies, now what is the flux I will get? Total flux. Now phi is equal to E 4 pi R square. Okay. So this is equation number 1. Now, the same process. I have to compare this flux with this Gauss rule. Okay. So let us compare it. So from this, or applying Gauss rule, again I will write applying Gauss law. Okay, what is the Gauss law? The same process, the flux, the total flux, phi is equal to the total charge enclosed the surface divided by epsilon g, I have already discussed. Okay, so that implies, what is the total charge I have to find out? Look at here. Here I am mean your sigma, sigma surface charge density, which is the, nothing but a q by a, that means the total charge q is equal to sigma into a, very simple. So sigma into a is your total, that means that implies total charge q is equal to sigma a, box it, let us put the value here. So that is sigma a divided by epsilon 0, this is your equation number 2. Okay, so now let us compare this equation number 1 and equation number 2, comparing it, then we compare. What I can write? Now E 4 pi r square is equal to sigma a divided by epsilon g. Very simple. So that implies E is equal to, okay. Clear all of you? Okay. So sigma a, so E is equal to, that is sigma a divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 r square, or simply in place of sigma a you can also write down the q. So q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 r square. So this is your final expression, I mentioned equation number 3. So this is your final expression of electric field intensity due to an uniformly charged spherical cell at a point outside the cell. This is very important. The point is present outside the cell. What is the expression of electric field intensity? Now this one. E is equal to sigma a divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 r square. You can also remember. Or you can also remember q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 r square. This is up to you. Okay. So this is your case number 1. Case number 1 solved. So let us discuss about the case number 2. Let us discuss about the case number 2. So what happens in the case number 2? So case number 2, the point P is present on this spherical cell, not outside, on this. So on this means this small r value must be equal to capital R value. If this point P is come to this surface, then this capital R value must be equal to small r value. Okay. So the point here I have written, the point P is on the spherical cell. Okay. So that means capital R is equal to small r. Okay. So just write down the deletion. Everything is same. Okay. So just write down, I have to write down the value, because E is equal to same thing, that is Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0. Now the both are same, so you can also write down R square. Okay. Or simply Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 R square. Anything you can write, either this or this. Because why? Now because capital R is equal to small. Okay. And in place of Q, you can also write down sigma I is up to you, 4 pi epsilon 0 r square. So this is the expression of your electric field intensity due to a uniformly charged spherical cell at a point present on this spherical. This is very important. This is on this spherical cell. Okay. Where the radius of the spherical cell is equal to the distance of the point. That is R is equal to R. This is the case number 2. Okay. Now moving to the case number 3. Case number 3. Okay. The point P is in the spherical cell. Okay. That is the figure number 2. All of you look at the figure number 2. Okay. So in the figure number 2, I will take the point inside the spherical cell and I will name it as P dash. This is I take P and I can also take it as a P dash because it is present inside it. Okay. And in this, that distance from this center to P dash is smaller. And the, look at this, and the radius of the spherical cell is your capital. Okay, and this is your Gaussian surface. This dotted one is your Gaussian surface, which is imaginary one. Okay, so for this, we are going to find out the electric field intensity. Very simple. Okay, so let us find out the electric field intensity. So before that, again I will find out the flux. Same. So flux is equal to close integration E dot ds. Okay. Then the angle between EDS 0 degree, very simple. So close integration EDS, that is equal to close integration DS, that is equal to S. And what is the surface area? Look at this. For this surface area inside it, remember, for this surface it is present inside it. So that means this is again smaller. So that is equal to E 4 pi R square. Okay. Now this is your equation number 1. I will compare this equation number 1 to Gauss law. So according to Gauss law, the total flux is equal to total charge enclosed divided by epsilon g. But unfortunately, this is a very important point, but unfortunately, as the spherical cell, in this spherical cell, all the charge reside on the surface. Remember, all the charge reside on the surface. That's why no charge is present inside the spherical cell. It's a very important point. Remember, in the third case, again I will repeat, in the third case, when you are applying the Gauss law, what the Gauss law says? The Gauss law says that the total flux is equal to the total charge divided by epsilon 0. But in this case, the total charge only in this spherical cell, the total charge is only reside on the surface. There is no charge inside it. So that means, if there is no charge inside it, then what is the flux? Zero. So if I will compare these two, this is the equation number 2. Now comparing equation 1 and equation number 2. Comparing equation 1 and equation number 2. What I will get? Now I will get the electric field intensity. Value becomes zero. This is very important. So, this is your equation number 3. Remember, there is a very important conclusion I will get from this equation number 3. What conclusion? Now, for a uniformly charged spherical cell, if we are going to find out the electrical intensity at a point inside the spherical cell, then the electric field becomes zero. Because inside the spherical cell, there is presence of no charge. No charge region. And remember one point, this concept, this specifically this equation number 3 concept is applicable to a very physical phenomenon, important phenomenon that is called electrostatic shielding. You can look at into my notes, okay? There is the electrostatic shielding process. It's based on this equation number 3. What happens in the electrostatic shielding? In the electrostatic shielding, you have to make a region charge free or field free. Free from field, electric field. For example, I will take. Suppose you are in an energy, there is so many thunders, lightning, okay? So it is better to stay inside a bus than outside. Why? Because when you stay inside the bus, the body of the bus act like electrostatic shielding. Because what if there is a thunder or there is a lightning towards it, then the discharged charge becomes going towards the downward or earth. Okay, and you feel safe inside the bus. But if you are outside the bus, then you can feel a great thunder and you will be harmful and you may going towards the death. Okay, so this concept, this electrostatic field concept or the electrostatic shielding concept is generally based upon this case. This is case number 3. Okay, thank you so much.